It's hard to overstate how important an election year 2012 will be in Wisconsin. A likely recall election for the governor, the election of a new U.S. senator, and Wisconsin will once again be a battleground state in the presidential election. Along with all of this will come intense television advertising. Just how intense will it be? We're asking Ken Goldstein, director of Cantor Media's Campaign Analysis Group. He's in our bureau in Washington today. Ken, thanks very much for joining us. You said in a recent story with Craig Gilbert of the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel that we're entering uncharted territory. How so?
Well, so we've had states that have been battleground states for president. We've had states that have been battleground states for president and a Senate election. But to add, battleground for president, battleground Senate election, a competitive open Senate seat, plus a Republican primary for that Senate seat, plus a recall election for governor that's not occurring at the same time as those other races. So you'd have a ton of advertising if all three of those races were on the ballot at the same time, but there's only so much space on television stations that the television stations have to sell. But if that recall election happens earlier in the year, you're going to have massive spending on that. You could have massive spending like we saw in the recall elections just for state Senate. And then you add on to that, you could also have a couple competitive House races. Looking back at other states in other years, we've just simply never, ever had a state that's had so much going on in one year. So if you like political advertising in Wisconsin, it will be the place to be in 2012.
If you don't like it, though, you won't be able to escape it watching television. I mean, we will be inundated with ads. We're already seeing ads for the prospect of a recall election for the governor.
Yeah, you've already seen just in the last month or so over $2 million worth of ads on targeted mostly by Governor Scott Walker and his allies towards that possible recall, and we are many months before that, and we're 10 months before the general election. I went and looked, and Las Vegas this past 2010 year had a competitive gubernatorial race, a competitive Senate race. They had a couple competitive primaries there as well. There was 63,000 spots just in Las Vegas. So I think we're going to see those numbers and higher in Wisconsin media markets. So if you're a couch potato watching lots of television, yeah, you could literally see thousands of political ads.
Ken, do we have any idea how much all of this will cost when it's said and done?
So in the Wisconsin had a Senate election and a gubernatorial election in 2010. There was almost $50 million spent in that race. There was $25 million spent in the presidential race in 2008. But remember, John McCain didn't really play in Wisconsin, and essentially Barack Obama at some point knew he was going to win, and he lowered his advertising. Wisconsin's not going to be a big blowout in 2012 like it was in 2008. So you're going to see heavy spending in the presidential race, plus higher levels than that $50 million than we saw for governor and Senate in 2010. And then you add into the mix all these groups coming in, both in the state election, the gubernatorial election, and the federal races. It's really going to be, I can't think of an adjective to describe it.
And as someone who has studied this over the years, you hear a lot from people who have to watch these ads, and they say, boy, I'm tired of the tone. I'm tired. They seem so negative. They're a turnoff. But you argue that the reason for the tone is because they are effective. Is that not the truth?
Well, listen, a negative ad isn't automatically effective, and a positive ad isn't automatically ineffective. But in the environment we are nationally, in the environment we are in Wisconsin, people are often not voting so much for, but voting against. And defining your opponent right out of the box can be very crucial. Also, with so much clutter, so much noise of advertising, the quality of the message is going to be more important than usual to somehow shine through, to somehow have a signal that shines through. And political professionals believe that a good, I don't mean normatively good, but a well-crafted right, negative message is their best chance to shine through all of the noise that's going to certainly be showering the state of Wisconsin in 2012.
Well, so I think you or others have called it, we may be about to witness the perfect storm in terms of political advertising in Wisconsin. Ken Goldstein from Cantor Media Group, it's always good to have you on the program. Thanks very much for being with us, and Happy New Year to you.
Good. Happy New Year to you and everyone in Wisconsin.
Next, what we've seen in the past year and why this may be only the beginning.
Upfront is produced with editorial assistance from WisPolitics.com, an online government and political news service.